Okay, so what is it then? What challenges is the Philippines facing, considering the president today is even he's more palatable to the Western world, right? So if here's Duterte, you're saying, okay, take out Pogo, it's 8 billion. But this is a president who's actually he's more liked in the Western world. He's more business friendly. His whole personality, his the whole campaign, the whole foreign policy of this government. So why don't we have it?
We are told that he has struggled 19 times, right? 19 times since he assumed office. And we would have expected a surge of foreign direct investments that would follow his trips to these different destinations. But we are not seeing any of those yet. I think at the most, there was mention of about 700 billion likely to come, 700 billion likely to come pesos, not dollars, pesos because of his recent trips.
No,
So.
no, but my question is, what are the inherent problems in the Philippines for foreign direct investors? Because, for example, in Vietnam and Indonesia, I checked, and even Thailand, well, Thailand and Vietnam, foreigners also can't own land. In manufacturing in the Philippines, you can be 100% foreign owned. Power in the Philippines, you can be 100% foreign owned. So why aren't they coming to us?
Well, there's been mentioned a couple of times that it's because of red tape, corruption, and ease of doing business.
But did you experience this yourself? Did you see this when you were NEDA secretary?
I wasn't able to compare the this thing during our time with as far as restrictions are concerned or the inhibitions of foreigners. I think this thing about corruption, red tape, and ease of doing business, they are very important items to consider that we have not really gotten over.
Okay, Professor, so what do you see as the real intention of reviewing the charter? How do you define this?
I'm not in favor of tinkering with the charter because as Winnie Monsod said earlier, there really are many other things that we need to do rather than tinkering with the charter, with the constitution. So, and I think that is also what former Supreme Court Justice Carpio said, that we just need to change certain things that can be done without touching the Constitution or the Charter of the Constitution.
Okay, I wanted to ask you because off camera you said this was a hoax. Do you still stand by that? Is it a hoax?
It's in a way. I really meant that it's a hoax in terms of its way of trying to get more mileage for politicians, for congressmen and senators, more mileage in terms of term limits and other things that have to do with their presence in the Senate and Congress.
Okay. And I think last words, was it ever in the Philippine Development Plan that charter change was a factor? in improving the country's economic state?
I have been through a couple of Philippine Development Plan, and we did not touch the charter. We did not touch the constitution. We just mentioned, for example, the three items that that have been passed in Congress: the Public Service Act, Foreign Investment Act, and the Retail Trade Liberalization Act.
Mm. All right. On that note, I want to thank you for joining me today, former NEDA Secretary Ernesto Pernia. Thank you, sir. Be well. Thank you.
Thank you too, Ma'am Karen.